Once upon a time, an empire fell. The newly free lands were poor, grey and polluted. To stop chaos taking hold and to help these blighted economies recover, Western governments created a champion. It was a bank with a difference. A bank with a mission. To make these countries fairer, better, greener places. The shining light they created was the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development. Since then, our bank has given its golden hand to banks, industry and businesses, rescuing them from the dead grip of state control. Another difference about the EBRD is that when it has completed its mission and the countries in its fold are democracies with green, healthy economies, it should wind itself up. What more is there to tell? Perhaps you wish to know who finances the bank. Western governments do. They all have a stake in keeping the bank going. Of course, this money is invested wisely, going to those who need it most. The EBRD was created to help the common people of Eastern Europe. We watch our projects carefully to ensure that people are treated fairly, promoting the European Union's values of human rights. And the projects we involve ourselves in are environmentally sustainable, given that the European Union regards tackling climate change as its highest priority. But of course, it's not all hard work, and some of us at the bank like to enjoy ourselves from time to time. Over the short period of the past 20 years, we can claim great success. One of our 29 countries is now healthy enough to leave our care. In fact, we've been so successful that we don't actually need to wind ourselves up. Where would these economies be without our help? And now, the EBRD is considering expanding to the newly freed countries of Northern Africa. After their hard-won revolutions, toppling tyrants, who would be better suited to install human rights and rid them of corruption? On our 20th anniversary, we at the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development have never forgotten the ideals it was created with. Long live the EBRD!